In this video, we talk about strategy as it relates to finding additional profits and optimizing a company. So the first question, what boundaries have you set to keep your business on course? A lot of business owners will be here and there and trying different things, but if they were only to focus on their core offering, they might do so much better. So you might find some insight there. How are you spurring innovation among your staff? If an owner can get their staff on board to be thinking of new and creative ideas to grow, they could have a dramatic impact on the increase of a company. Third question, on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the greatest, how committed are your employees to helping other employees be more productive and successful? This might help you find a little insight about the environment, the working environment of a company, and perhaps some ideas that are holding everyone back there. How would your employees rate the business on its ability to change and keep up with industry changes? Which ranks the highest, the customers or employees or shareholders if you have them? Don't assume here that it's customers. Often business owners will say, nope, it's my employees that rank the highest. Are you doing today what your business needs to do to matter tomorrow? Great question. Could open up all kinds of conversation there. What are your ultimate strategic objectives? Now, I've left a little explanation here you can just hover over. And we talk about strategy as it relates to tactics. And maybe I'll have to move the screen over so you can capture everything. Strategy means you've determined in advance the ultimate goals you would like to achieve for each sales and marketing action. So think about this. Maybe someone goes on a sales call and you say, what do you want to achieve? And they say, well, I want to make a sale. So you say, what else is there? And maybe they want, of course, to generate more referrals or arm the clients with better information. You know, you can sell, a client can sell to a CEO in 1 hour. But if they're selling to someone who doesn't have the ability to make that buying decision, they might get an hour with that person, but then that person goes and tries to explain it in 5 minutes to the CEO. They can't do the job that the salesperson will do. So maybe you want to arm that client with better information. Or perhaps you want to be known as the source of innovative ideas or have people trust you or respect you. So the question then becomes, if you can teach them that a little bit, you say, now if we chose 3 to 5 strategic objectives and you utilize those every time you initiate a marketing tactic, what impact would that have on your overall growth? Normally there's something here, 5 or 10%, it might be much higher, but be very conservative. And I'm going to put, just for the sake of the entire spreadsheet, I'm going to put just a 3% in there because that's believable and achievable. Now, if they say, yes, we do think through our ultimate strategic objectives, you can follow that up with another question to test them. When you go on a sales call, how many purposes do you have for making that meeting besides making a sale? If they have a lot, then you want to know what they are. If they don't have many, of course, if you chose 3 to 5, what impact would it have? Or if they say, well, we've got lots, then you can say, are you consistent in them? If they say no, you're asking that first question again. If you chose 3 to 5 and you could consistently utilize them, what impact would that have? If they say, yes, I am consistent, then do you see other opportunities to be more strategic? At this point, they might. If not, you might just end right there. If they say, yeah, you can add them and write them down. And then, again, state the impact on your business in that final box. So on this page, you should find at least 3 or 5%, perhaps much more.